Thank you very much. And have you ever been hypnotized? Well, our next guest says that you're getting hypnotized every single day. We'll find out more when we come back. Hi, everybody. Good morning. Colin Rosati is here with me. He is a master hypnotist.
Mm-hmm.
Already, Ruth's like, don't look in his eyes. And I was joking. Yeah, that's right. I was joking earlier that I was going to get knocked out and end up barking like a dog and clucking like a chicken. That's not the kind of hypnotism we're talking about.
No, it's not. We do mostly clinical hypnosis. So we help people to stop smoking, lose weight, and do this really great thing, which helps people meet their true love. Believe it or not.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Okay, so we'll get to that in a minute. But the other thing that I was saying just as we went to break is I've never been hypnotized, so I think, but you're saying that we in some form are being hypnotized every day?
Yeah, well, when people think of hypnosis, they think of the traditional trance. So they think of you're getting sleepy. But really, you pop in and out of trances all the time. Your mind goes a little bit blurry sometimes when you're driving. You know, they call it highway hypnosis or driving hypnosis when you're driving.
Yeah.
So many times, say, university students in math class in the big lecture theaters are there and they're like, and all of a sudden they sort of know the equation.
So like deep daydreaming.
It's like a
daydream. And you're still hearing something even though your mind sort of left the
room. That's right. So hypnosis really is bypassing the critical conscious mind and really getting into the programming of the subconscious. So although traditionally we use the trance, and in a clinic you'll use a trance, and on stage you'll use a trance, it's not really necessary anymore.
Mm-hmm.
So all you have to do is get past the conscious resistance. So there are lots of times in the workplace you might want to get past your employees.
If you're an employer.
Yeah, and you want them to do what you tell them to do.
Yeah, without a fight.
But how
do you do this? So if I'm the employer, you're the employee, what am I doing to you to hypnotize you that you aren't even aware that it's being done?
Well, there's verbal communication, and then there's gestures, which draw the energy in. So you're doing it a little bit right now. For example, if you're a lawyer and you're talking to a jury, or if you have a presentation coming up, or you're talking to your group in a team meeting, if something is good, you want to anchor those feelings to you, like, hey, you know, Calgary won is good, Calgary won is bad.
Oh, you pull
right.
your
hand. Yeah, and you can help them focus like this, but, you know, Leafs out of the playoffs, that's bad, right?
Mm-hmm.
Get that away from you. And so those are preliminary things. And the really fascinating things is we can see this in high-level politics right now. So, of course, I don't know if you remember Clinton.
Yes.
But he was a master of this. And he'd stand on stage and say, I can feel your pain. And he'd draw in millions and millions of Americans. Or he'd say, oh, that's the economy. This is bad. This is bad.
Yes. And push it away from himself. But he did this thing all the time. Was that a thing that was specific? Because then I'm sure I saw Dalton McGuinty doing this thing with the making a point and being emphatic. What is this?
Yeah, well, that's exactly what they're doing. They're making a point and they're punctuating it. So if you're, say you're a woman and somebody's making approaches to you and you want them to get right into their right way, say, stop, right? And you use the hand gestures. Or if you're at a party and you want someone to come towards you, you kind of wink and, you know, bring them in. Canadian politicians, our system is a little different than the American system. And we have, it's based around the media scrum. So if you're in a scrum, can't be using these gestures, or you can, but they just won't see it.
Scrum being all, if you're not familiar, all the media when they're like tight around one person getting the interview.
So for Canadian politicians, they're using more along the lines of hypnotic language to get something past your conscious mind so that you're saying it all the time. So if there's a slogan or something, I mean, it just sounds like a slogan or advertising or something like that, but in the back of your head, you're saying, common sense revolution.
Right,
whoa,
right.
Sounds good. And then the difference between a hypnotic suggestion and regular suggestion is there comes a point where it actually becomes your own. And you think, oh, geez.
You make people think they came up with it. Obviously, they don't think they wrote the comment, but they think suddenly they've decided it's a good idea when in fact someone else has told them.
That's exactly right.
Right. Now, as far as you were saying before, we have to go, we have about a minute. When you were saying you can bring love to you and things like that, is it the same kind of idea? If you meet someone you like, you're giving off those?
Well, in something like hypnotic seduction, and we're going to have workshops on this at the Learning Annex this summer, there are two parts to it. The first happens in a clinical situation. We remove the blocks which are preventing you from achieving your dreams. And there are a lot of blocks there. You can see love right across the aisle from you all the time. So, that kind of thing.
Yeah. But you may not even know. You might be a person who's saying, I just never meet someone, but you have something going on.
That happens all the time.
Right.
It's, I can't meet anybody. I'm like, oh, give me a break. And then the other part is to draw them into you, because maybe you really do, and maybe you are free, and maybe you just don't know what to do. Maybe you're sending out the wrong signals.
Yeah. So it's not so much that you're hypnotizing someone into something as you're convincing them subtly.
Yeah, telling them that perhaps you really want to go out with me or something like that.
Yeah, and then they
or you really want to follow my instructions.
Yeah, let's do that with everybody. That's great. Colin Rosati, thank you so much. He is a master hypnotist. Nice talking to you.
Oh, thanks for having me.
Here's Anne.